I enlisted 1 year out of high school in 1975. I served from December 75 to December 79. I was on the USS Austin, LPD-4, stationed in Norfolk. Did a number of tours in the North Atlantic, the Mediterranean, and the Caribbean. And spent a year in the shipyards in Baltimore Shipbuilding and Dry Dock. Was honorably discharged in December of 79. In late September 2011, my free market health insurance had grown to a combined cost of $2,800 per month, premiums and prescription drug costs. I had a heart issue and had a number of stents, and nobody can afford $2,800 a month. Nobody, I don't care who you are. And so I pursued my relationship with the VA that I was entitled to.
I met Mr. Turner several years ago when he was referred to cardiology for evaluation and treatment of his ischemic heart disease. All of the cardiologists in our department will do whatever it takes to see that the patients get the best possible care. I think, in Mr. Turner's case, he's gotten exceptional care from all of the cardiologists that he's seen within the VA.
And when I came and saw him, Dr. Rosenberg, I mentioned that on my neck, a lump had just popped up, seemingly overnight, literally. So I was there to see him for my heart, and he was there examining me at the same time for this lump. He looked at it, measured it, felt it, looked at the intern that was with him, and as soon as we were done, sent me over to Dr. Moffitt, ENT, extraordinaire, who immediately, again without an appointment, did a biopsy right then and there. I came back in 5 days to get what I thought was going to be an antibiotic for an inflammation in the lymph node. Took me into the office, sat me down and said, no, it's not an inflammation, it's cancer. It's a very aggressive cancer, rated 19.2 on a scale of 1 to 20 for aggressiveness. And we don't have any time.
I met Mr. Turner late in 2014 upon referral from the ear, nose, and throat department because he had a mass in his left neck that was biopsied to be cancerous.
The day I got the biopsy results, I also got a PET scan done. You can't get that done anywhere. You can't get that kind of service and that kind of treatment unscheduled. I got that here at the VA.
Hopefully that would have ended his string of malignancy, but he ultimately then develops a second cancer in his thyroid gland that was not treated with chemotherapy, but rather with radioactive iodine by Dr. Thomas.
I came in again. I don't think I waited 10 days to get an appointment. Saw the ENT. They then sent me over to have a biopsy done of my thyroid. It was a Thursday before Veterans Day that fall. And I asked the doctor, I said, when should I expect to get results back? He said, well, today's Thursday. He said, tomorrow's Friday. And Monday's the holiday. So you'll probably get a call Tuesday or Wednesday. The next morning, I got a call from 5 different members of my primary team care unit. The cardiologist, the ENT, my oncologist, Dr. Weick, the PET scan schedule, and one other I can't recall offhand. They all progressively called me the following morning, lining up what needed to be done as it related, and the surgeon, excuse me, that needed to be done as it related to this next step in my care here at the VA. So they were looking at me as the whole and total patient, not just as a patient that had a heart condition or a cancer problem. They were looking at David Turner as a whole, and they were treating me as a whole.
Approximately a year later, He develops respiratory symptoms, and a biopsy of his lung showed that he had a mesothelioma, yet a third malignancy, not related at all to the other two malignancies.
And that's a hard thing to process. But when I went to see my thoracic surgeon, Dr. Mata, and in talking to him, he said, talk to Dr. Weick about Duke. Saw Dr. Weick, I believe, the next day. And I said, Dr. Weick, Dr. Mata said I should talk to you about Duke. He said, it's already done. I got a call from outside VA services the next day. He said, I don't know how this is, but you're going to Duke. And you're already approved. 24 hours. And from that point on, I was flown back and forth to Duke Medical Center to see the best oncologists in the country, the best thoracic surgeons in the country. And just before Thanksgiving, a PET scan was requested by Duke Medical Center so they could get something up to date. That was a Monday, before Thanksgiving. Everything was booked. And I talked to them, I said, ask Ben if he can get me in. Ben came in on his own time. It's 7 o'clock the next morning to get the PET scan done because he knew I needed it. It wasn't scheduled. It wasn't months in advance. It wasn't weeks in advance. It was the next morning after I requested it.
So here's a gentleman who still looks 100%, still performs his occupation, has been through almost as many personal problems as he has medical problems, I think unrelated, and is just a real wonderful patient to take care of.
I have never encountered an issue in which I wasn't treated with complete respect and concern for me as the person and me as the patient. If I had to wait for a half an hour for an appointment, it was unusual. I've never had problems in getting appointments in a timely manner. And this is over the course of 4 or 5 years now. I can only say this to any of the young men and young women out there that are watching this, that do yourself a favor and do your family a favor and reach out to your VA. They owe it to you. You served your country. You're entitled to good health care. And in my experience, from a personal basis, the best health care available in the country.